Hello, dear friends. It's a beautiful Tuesday afternoon in Milton, Ontario, and I'm sitting on our front porch and enjoying this time and preparing this video, which is to be posted tomorrow, Wednesday, September 23rd. Well, I want to begin with a prayer, which is about protection, and protection for us to fulfill the purposes of God in these precarious days. This is a collect. Almighty and merciful God, in your goodness, keep us, we pray, from all things that may hurt us, that we, being ready both in mind and body, may accomplish with joyful hearts those things which belong to your purpose, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. These are precarious times, but it is wonderful to think about the faithfulness of God and Him fulfilling His purposes. If I was to say, He who calls you is faithful, He will surely do it, and you were to say, aha, that's 1 Thessalonians 5:24, I would say, full marks for you. That's absolutely right. And if you were to further go on and say, I happen to know that that's the theme verse for the Fall Synod, November 4th and 5th, 2020, for the Anglican Network in Canada, which will be an online synod and will be based on this theme verse, He who calls you is faithful, He will surely do it, I'd say double full marks for you. And for a couple of weeks, we thought about Joshua, and 100% of God's promises are fulfilled. And we thought about Balaam and how he said, God is not a man that he should lie, or the son of man that he should repent. Has he said it and shall he not do it? Has he spoken and shall he not make it good? Numbers 23:19. God always says what he means what he says, doesn't change his mind, and he's able and does deliver on his promises. That's what it means for God to be faithful. Well, when you think of the faithfulness of God, you've got to think about Jesus, who is the faithful one. He is the faithful one, the very Son of God. It says God, he was sent into the world not to condemn the world, but that the world might be saved through him. He came with a purpose. His very name speaks about that. And John 3:17, that's what it says. And so as the faithful one, by John 12, we read how Jesus prayed, now is my soul troubled, and what shall I say? Father, save me from this hour. But for this purpose, I came to this hour. Father, glorify your name. Then a voice came from heaven, I have glorified it, and I will glorify it again. The Father glorifying the Son, who is the faithful one, and the faithful one glorifying the Father. So it is that by John 13 at the Last Supper, it says, now before the feast of the Passover, when Jesus knew that his hour had come to depart out of this world to the Father, having loved his own who were in the world, he loved them to the end. This is Jesus, the faithful one. And so when he said, let not your heart be troubled, believe in God, believe also in me. I go to prepare a place for you, and if I go, I will come again, that where I am, there you may be also. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. It's because he's the faithful one. And so in John 17, in his high priestly prayer, Jesus, the Son, the faithful one, says to the Father, I glorified you on earth, having accomplished the work that you gave me to do. Jesus is the faithful one. Hallelujah. And so by John 19, there on the cross, in those final moments, it says, verse 28 of John 19, after this, Jesus, knowing that all was now finished, this is concerning the faithful one, so said, to fulfill the scripture, I thirst. A jar full of sour wine stood there, so they put a sponge full of the sour wine on a hyssop branch and held it to his mouth. When Jesus had received the sour wine, he said, it is finished. And he bowed his head and gave up his spirit. This, it is finished, was the faithful one acknowledging in a glorious way that everything that the Father had given him to do for the sake of an otherwise condemned and judged human race that were lost without him. Jesus gloriously and wonderfully secured it all in his cross and by his glorious resurrection. Jesus is the faithful one. You want to think about the faithfulness of God, and we do, you got to think about Jesus, and you have to think about his cross. Well, dear friends, we're going to have one more week on the He Who Calls You is Faithful, and then we'll be thinking in October about the call of God. I just want to conclude by saying that I would really appreciate your prayer for John Coughlin, who is to be ordained to the diaconate this coming Saturday, September 26th. Over the next weeks, there are a number of people who are to be ordained, and I'll try to name them so you can be praying. But for this Saturday, John Coughlin in Napanee, Ontario, part of St. Stephen's Anglican Fellowship, the rector is the Reverend David Smith. Really appreciate if you pray for him. Also really appreciate if you pray for Bishop Trevor. I wanted to say that I'm so grateful that the end of last week, he traveled up to Whitehorse from Victoria, Whitehorse, Yukon, to be there for the graveside service for Bishop Terry Buckle. I mentioned him and to be with Blanche and the family at that very wonderful service. And then he traveled right back, and on Monday, Bishop Trevor had surgery, which was kind of a follow-up. You'll maybe remember that he had surgery in early 2018. And so I would love it if you'd pray for him in these coming days as he recovers, and for the report which he'll get as well. So all these things, would you pray? And it's so wonderful when we pray. We're praying to a God who is faithful. The Lord bless you. And dear friends, let's not forget, as I have not done in the last few weeks, but say every opportunity you've got, speak to people about the faithful one who is Jesus. Open your mouth and speak about Jesus. God bless you.